bow our hearts to you, Lord. We're humbled by your presence, by your love. Lord, because you first loved us, now we have some semblance of love for you.
Yes, God.
God, not because we were so noble-minded or we're so holy, but because we've been slowly being conquered by your love. We've started to love you more and more. God, in such a night as this, Lord, we rejoice in the opportunity to draw near. To draw near to the Savior. To draw near to our God and King. Beautiful is our God. Lofty and lovely is our King. Lord, our only request this night is that we might fellowship and commune with you. God, we're not after some hyped up, excited meeting, but rather, God, we want to commune with you. Lord, we desire to meet with the Almighty. God, what a bold request that we would ask to meet with the Almighty, an audience with the Lord. We long for you, Lord. We long for the Lord. We long, Lord, for you. And so we offer ourselves as an offering, as a sacrifice tonight. We offer ourselves. We offer ourselves, Lord, to you. As a sacrifice, as an offering. We want to say we love you. Many ways and many times tonight, we want to say that we love you. So God, we offer ourselves as an offering.
There is none like you.
Two verses crying out holy to the Lord in the presence of your infinite might.
Thank you. Holy God, yeah, 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 holy, holy God. Come on and sing to the Lord tonight. We release the strings of His presence, oh Lord. We release the strings of His spirit, oh Lord. We release the strings of Your presence, oh Lord.
Sat on the throne a book, written inside and on the back, sealed up with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the book and to break its seals?" And no one in heaven, on the earth, or under the earth was able to open the book or to look into it. And I began to weep greatly, because no one was found worthy to open the book or to even look into it. And one of the elders said to me, "Stop weeping. Behold, the Lion that is from the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has overcome so as to open the book and its seven seals." And I saw between the throne with the four living creatures and the elders a lamb standing as if slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all the earth. And he came, and he took it out of the right hand of him who sat on the throne. And when he had taken the book, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, having each one a harp and golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, "Worthy art thou to take the book, to break its seals, for thou wast slain and did purchase for God with thy blood men from every tribe, every tongue, every people, and every nation. And thou hast made them to be a kingdom and priests to our God, and they will reign upon the earth." Hallelujah to the Lamb. And I looked, and I heard the voice of many angels around the throne, and the living creatures, and the elders, and the numbers of them was myriads of myriads, and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power, and riches, and wisdom, and might, honor, glory, and blessing, to receive power, riches, wisdom, might,
blessing and every created thing which is in heaven and on the earth and under the earth and on the sea and all things in them, I heard saying, to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing, be honor, be glory, dominion forever. To the awesome Lamb, blessing and glory and honor.
If the kingdom of darkness has been hearing it lately, but there's a holy roar that God's bringing forward. But you got to go to the secret place to find it. It's in the secret place before the mighty Lamb of God. Been hearing it all week. You can hear it in your spirit if you're listening. It's a holy roar. You know, there's work to be done tonight. We're having a night of worship where we're wholly devoted, but there's work to do. We're going to be praying for people in just a little bit, giving you some forewarnings so that you can think about it and we can form up accurate words to pray. With all this strength and energy and power of the Holy Spirit that's in this house tonight, I want us to pray for the wounded, for the backslidden, for the hurt. See, it's one thing to come into his presence and be good and edified. It's another to slip right over into prayer. Intermingling our praise with prayer, God. Our worship with intercession. We're learning to intermingle our praise with prayer, God. And our worship with intercession. I believe the Lord has put a sword in each man and woman's hand tonight that you're able to do surgery. And so I want you to be thinking about that. We're going to teach you a song tonight, Awesome in This Place. And we're going to declare it before we ever see it. When we come into the presence of the Almighty, He's awesome in this place. You can tell by the power that you're possessing in your spirit in this moment.
As I come into your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, till we're standing face to face, I look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your grace. And I can only bow down and say,
You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father.
Church, let's learn it from the beginning together.
And as I come to your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, till we're standing face to face, I look upon your countenance. I see the fullness of your grace, and I can only bow down and say, You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father.
To you, our lives, we give.
pray, church? I want everyone to be seated. Tonight specifically, we're going to pray for the wounded. Now first we're going to do it here. Maybe this is the first meeting you've been in all week. Maybe you've been here all 3 days. We've had some significant words and times of getting it right with the Lord. This is how I want us to pray tonight. If you feel, man, you've had the strength of God just kind of ebbing out of your members, and you really need, you're saying, God, I need a touch from you, Lord. I mean, maybe you feel, I've been so disappointed for so very long. I've been so disappointed for so very long. I've been so hurt deep inside. Lord, what's wrong with me? Some of you said, now we're has the Lord turned aside? Come quickly, Lord, and be by my side. Oh, Father, I'm trying. Don't you see I'm trying to abide? Well, then the answer comes from heaven. I'm the balm of I know you've been hurt and I'm trodden. I know your heart has been sad. But now look unto my Jesus. On Calvary he did go to bring you forth from the times of hurt. These times now of healing you would know. For I am for you more than you can understand. I have not left you an orphan, still moving on your heart with my hand. Did you forget now? I am the great I am. Great I am. So look up to heaven. I can heal your deepest hurt. Look up to heaven. You will know for sure that I am. My arm is not short to heal or deliver your hurting heart. Your hurting heart. Your hurting heart. I know tonight you are sad, but I can make you glad. I can make you glad. I can restore you deep in your spirit, even though there's been a dull. My children, give me your heart tonight, Lord. All the wounded, all the downtrodden, all those that have been hurt deeply in their hearts, I want you to stand to your feet. We're going to pray that healing and restoration of the Son of God. I don't care how hard,
how long he carried it. God's going to do his work tonight. Might be in your spirit, your soul.
Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget none of his benefits, who pardons all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases.
It's the night of restoration of the brokenhearted.
Jeremiah 30:17. For I will restore you to health, and I will heal you of your wounds, declares the Lord.
Jeremiah 17:14. Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me, and I will be saved, for thou art my praise.
Malachi 4:2. But for you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness will arise with healing in his wings. And you will go forth and skip about like calves from the stall. But for you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness will arise with healing in his wings.
Free indeed. Well, you are free. He who the
that's free is free in their deed. Sunsets free is free in their deed. Just announcing it. I feel good, Lord. Oh, man. I want people to go back and be pumped and primed to go to their church and just stay in love with Jesus and help folks. We're just musical servants. That's all we are, man. We're just musical servants. Some of us sing, some of us play, some of us make a joyful noise. Oh, now, come on. There should have been more than that on that. Make it. Okay, open your Bibles to Ecclesiastes, last one. Remember, we're in that pondering, meditative, reflective mode. We're going to get this yet, man. Well, verse 1, let's take a look at this, chapter 12. Remember also your Creator in the days of your youth, before the evil days come and the years draw near, when you will say, I have no delight in this. Before the sun, the light, and the moon, the stars are darkened, and clouds return after the rain, in the day when the watchmen of the house tremble and the mighty men stoop, the grinding ones, the mill workers, stand idle because they are few, and those who look through windows grow dim. Oh, what a picture. And the doors in the street are shut as the sound of the grinding mill is low. And one will arise at the sound of the bird, and all the daughters of song will sing softly. Furthermore, men are afraid of a high place and of terrors on the road. The almond tree blossoms, the grasshopper drags himself along. The caperberry even is ineffective. For man goes to his eternal home while mourners go about in the street. Remember him before the silver cord is broken and the golden bowl gets crushed, which talks about life and the spinal cord. The pitcher by the wheel is shattered now, and the wheel at the cistern is now crushed. Then the dust will return to the earth as it was, and the spirit of a man will return to God who gave it. Verse 8, vanity of vanities. Says the preacher, all is vanity. In addition to being wise, or a wise man, the preacher also taught the people knowledge. And he pondered, he searched out, and he arranged many proverbs. The preacher sought to find delightful words and to write words of truth correctly. The words of wise men are like goads, and the masters of these are collections
of these collections are like well-driven nails, for you see they're given by one shepherd. Is a capital in your Bible too? They're given by one shepherd. What a statement in the Old Testament. For beyond this, my son, be warned, the writing of many books is endless, and the excessive devotion to books is wearying to the body. So the conclusion, when all has been heard, fear God, keep his commandments, because this applies to every person. For God will bring every act to judgment, everything which is hidden, whether it be evil or whether it be good. I want you to read verse 13 with me out loud. Ready? The conclusion.
When all has been heard, is fear God and keep his commandments.
Well, that's so good. Let's try that again. The conclusion, when all has been heard, is fear God and keep his commandments, because this applies to every person. Here's the song that goes with it. The conclusion, when all has been heard. I mean, after all the books and all the teaching and all the time together, what's left, church? What's left for us right now to do to invest our lives in? What would it be? Well, this is it for me, for sure. The conclusion, when all has been heard, is fear God and keep his commandments. The conclusion, when all has been heard, fear the Lord. The conclusion, when all has been heard, is fear God and keep his commandment. And surely this applies to every person. Surely this applies to every person. Try it again with me, let's learn it. Well, the conclusion when all has been heard is fear God and keep his commandment. The conclusion when all has been heard, fear the Lord. Well, the conclusion when all has been heard, is fear God and keep his commandment. Surely this applies to every person. And surely this applies to every person. Remember your think back on your Creator before the mighty men fall and stoop and the watchmen are found crying and trembling on their knees, and the daughters of the song of the Lord are singing oh so softly. Fear God and keep his commandments. The conclusion when all has been heard, fear the Lord. Well, the conclusion when all has been heard is fear God and keep his commandments. Surely this applies to every person. Surely this applies to every person. The conclusion, and the conclusion when all has been heard, is fear God and keep his commandments. The conclusion when all has been heard, fear the Lord. And the conclusion when all has been heard, is fear God. Applies to every person.
surely this applies to every verse.
Now hear the second verse.
Think back on the Lord of life. Before the silver cord is broken, remember the Lord of life. Before the golden bowl is crushed and the spirit of man will return unto his maker. Vanity, all is vanity. I can hear the preacher say, in the conclusion when all is good, is fear God and keep his commandments. The conclusion when all has been heard, fear the Lord. The conclusion when all has been heard is fear God and keep his commandments. Surely this applies to every person. Surely this applies to every
one more time.
The conclusion in all has been heard is fear God and keep his commandments. The conclusion in all has been heard, fear the Lord. The conclusion in all has been heard is fear God and keep his commandments. And surely this applies to every person. And surely this applies to every person.